Reviewing shots and providing feedback has never been easier with Silhouette. In this quick video, we'll explore the new markup tool and see how it can streamline the QA process. Here in Silhouette 2024.5, if you select a Roto node, you'll notice a new tool in your toolbar on the left, that is the markup tool. It was designed to simplify collaborative work when someone else is handling the rotoscoping for you, but you spot some inaccuracies that needs fixing. Let's see how it works. To create a markup, choose the markup tool in the toolbar, then click and drag anywhere in the viewer to draw a freehand stroke. It almost feels like painting. A markup object will appear in the objects list, and you can type in your notes in the text field over here. Alternatively, you can shift-click and drag to mark the area with a rectangle, or control-click and drag to draw an arrow. Each individual markup object has its own node, color that you can change, the range, and completion parameter. By default, the range is set to the frame where the stroke was created. So if I scrub forward, markups from the first frame won't be visible. However, you can easily extend the range as needed. Markup ranges are also displayed in the timeline. Markups can also be tracked when placed in a tracked layer. This is especially useful when the area or the object that you want to highlight moves across the frame or when there are multiple similar objects in the shot. Like here. We have multiple shapes for multiple cars. But if you look closely, you'll notice that some cars are missing certain parts. For instance, this one is missing its side view mirror. This one doesn't have the shape for its spare tire on the back. And another one is missing the roof rack on the top. Providing feedback by saying something like "fix roto for the white car" or sending a bunch of screenshots isn't the best practice. By attaching markups to the exact car layers, you're making it crystal clear what needs to be fixed. I'll start with this car at the bottom. With the markup tool selected, I hold Ctrl and draw an arrow pointing to the mirror that's missing. The markup element is created within the active layer. Next, I would extend the range to cover the entire duration of the clip. So the start frame should be 1 and the end frame is 250. Then I can leave a note in the text field and type in something like "add mirror shape". And I'm done with my first markup. This is how it looks in motion. Cool, let's create another one. For this one, I will draw a simple freehand stroke just like this. But take a look at the object list. While drawing, I still had the first car's layer set to active. If you accidentally create a markup on the wrong layer, you can simply drag and drop it to the right one, just like with any other object. The second markup element should be in the car 9 layer, which is green. If your markup jumps to a different place on the screen, like mine did here, you can simply click on it and move it back to the right spot. Done! I would type in another note for this one and extend the range. And finally, let's make a note for this last car. Again, I would find the dedicated layer in the object list, set it to active, then draw a freehand stroke with the markup tool. Set the range and leave a note. By reviewing the project and leaving discrete notes like this, you can prevent any potential misunderstanding. Sometimes only a specific section of the clip needs to be fixed, The range parameter in Markup tool is useful when adjustments are required only for certain parts. Here's a good example. I have a quite dense Roto node here. It's a bit hard to see what's going on, so I would disable the tool overlays and hit A to see only the alpha. The footage is a bit dark, so I would also bring up the gain a bit. And immediately I can see that we are missing some of the hair strands in this area. However, if I scrub forward, the woman turns her head and the issue is no longer appears. So I can mark up only the range where the problem exists. This keeps the project organized and clear. As soon as I start drawing, the overlays turn back on. The start frame is automatically set to 1000, and that's fine for this markup. Now I scrub forwards, finding a frame where the issue no longer exists. Somewhere around 1040 looks okay to me. And I set this as the end frame for this markup. Then I would type in the note, add more strands, and we're done with the first markup. Now I can scrub through the timeline and continue reviewing the shot in the same manner. Once that's done, I can save the project and send it back for a revision. Now let's look at the same shot from the other side. Imagine you are the one receiving notes and needing to make corrections to the Roto. When you open the project, it may be difficult to see all the markups in the viewer since we have so many shapes. Finding markups in the object list might also be inconvenient. The best way to view all the notes is to click on this icon on the top. This opens the sidebar on the right side of the viewer, showing all the notes assigned to the selected Roto node. When you select a node in the list, the callout line points to the specific markup in the viewer, and the time bar automatically jumps to the start frame of the specific markup's range. This way, you can quickly navigate between markups, making the review process more efficient. The completion checkbox for each node can also be found in the notes list. Once you've made the necessary fixes, simply mark each node as complete and deliver the project. Bonus tip. You can export and import just the notes as a simple JSON file. To export, head over to the Actions menu, Notes, click Export, and choose where you want to save the file. To import the notes, follow to the same menu, click Import, choose the file, and your notes will be updated. Keep in mind that the objects in your project must match those in the exported file for the import to work correctly. The new markup tool in Silhouette 2024.5 greatly simplifies the review process by allowing you to create, manage, and view notes directly on your shot. Try it on your next project and let us know what you think. My name is Elizabeth Postol for Boris Facts. Bye for now!